Technology's working. Let's see. Got that blue light again, blue circle. I think everything's good. Hold on. Anyway, while we're waiting, oh, there we go. Looks like it's good. Okay, so while we're waiting, today I want to talk to you guys a little bit about like whether you're feeling overwhelmed and sort of, you know, three specific things that you can do about that. So let's go ahead and get started. Okay, let me get my little notes up here. Okay, here we go. So this sort of activity is called self-inventory. And if we start with the basics, we all know that each day we wake up. We wake up. And basically what we accomplish and how we feel about the day, that largely comes from our attitude. So we have to sort of ask ourselves the questions, what's influencing my attitude? And am I really in control of that? Right? So for me, all this stuff is, you know, it comes from experience. So for me, I'm not a morning person at all. Mornings are a challenge for me, no matter how you slice it and dice it. I can, you know, it doesn't matter how much I sleep. It doesn't matter how early or how late I wake up. It doesn't matter if I have, you know, upbeat music playing in the background. It doesn't matter if I work out in the morning. It just, none of it matters. Waking up for me in the mornings are definitely a chore, and they probably always will be. So for me, it's because mornings, they all feel alike no matter what. It's very easy for me to go through my day without really checking in with myself, especially the morning portion of it, because it pretty much feels the same. But how I feel at the end of the day, that part comes from how I start my mornings and how I start the night before. So even though, like I said, mornings are difficult, the reason why this is so important, this whole self-inventory idea, is that, you know, how I go through the first few hours of my day, whether I'm feeling drowsy and groggy or whatever, the key is that the way I want to feel at the end of my day is through taking inventory, essentially, of myself, right? So regardless of whether you're a morning person or kind of a night owl like me, you know, take some time to think about at least one of these three questions that I'm going to ask you, especially if you're feeling overwhelmed right now, and even if you're not, because it's still important to check in with ourselves. So I'm going to add some more questions to the list and go over those with you tomorrow during tomorrow's live. But the first question is what have I done to make my body stronger? Okay, so really think about that for your own self. What have I done to make my body stronger? If the answer to that question is nothing or not much, then you know where to start, right? So if you're feeling overwhelmed and overworked, it's even more vital to take time to make your body physically stronger and healthier and to make sure that it's better than it was the day before, right? And so the great thing about the human body is that, you know, the more that you work out and the more that you train it, the stronger it will get, which isn't really like most things. Most things kind of deteriorate over time, but the more you work out those muscles, the better you're going to be. So for me, I consider working out, you know, a duty, whether it's 10 minutes a day, 30 minutes, hours, doesn't matter, but it's a duty. And so, you know, I will actually tell myself that it's essentially my moral obligation to keep my body healthy and strong. So, you know, and the reason for that is so that I can do the job that I was meant to do, teaching, to the highest level of my ability. Right? And if I don't do that, then it's really a disservice for the kids and the kids that I teach and really everybody around me, right? So question one, what am I doing to make my body stronger? What have I done? And if the answer is nothing or no or not much, then start there, right? And that's going to help you get some more control in your life and feel better. The second question is, am I reading my affirmations, right? So you might kind of scoff at that and might just brush it off. But if the answer to that is no, definitely contact me and I can help you with this, especially because I have a course called Thriving as a Teacher and I've been working with some clients and it's been amazing. So the affirmation piece to this is really key beyond the physical because, you know, I know for most mega successful people, and I don't mean just rich people, but just mega successful people, they read, they meditate, and they reflect on affirmations daily. And it's a habit for them, and it's become a habit for me. And I can totally tell the difference between, like, if I go 2 weeks and I don't read my affirmations, can totally tell the difference between the type of person that I am at the end of that 2 weeks compared to who I am when I have done it, right? So, you know, those super mega successful people, they don't scoff at affirmations. They don't skip it because they know that it's vital to their continued upward trajectory of their, you know, success. So for me, right, how much more so is it vital? You know, because personally I struggle with feelings of self-worth and confidence, right? So it's absolutely vital for me to train my mind and to feed my subconscious with positive things and statements that are going to allow me to be the best version of myself. So again, reach out, and I definitely can help you with this, and I want to help you with this. So the third question, this is the last question of the day, is, you know, and again, there's going to be more questions tomorrow, is, do I know what I will be doing first thing tomorrow when I get to work? Do I know what I will be doing first thing tomorrow when I get to work? In other words, have I written my to-do list for the following day or for the next day? So this question is kind of a big question for me personally, because even though mornings are a challenge for me, right, I can totally tell the difference in the way that I feel when I get to work. You know, if I have my running to-do list written the night before, it's a huge difference, night and day. And so, you know, yes, it is true, right, that I can just write the to-do list when I get to work the same day, right? But when I do that, I can tell the difference because at that point I'm always in scramble mode. I'm always have that feeling of sort of being behind the eight ball, so to speak, if I do it the day of. So, you know, I also, just as a side note, I also start my day doing the same three things when I get to work. It's almost like a ritual for me, and it just kind of helps put my head in a good place. And then it also gives me sort of a feeling of accomplishment, you know, because I've accomplished these three things, and it enables me to then focus full force on the other things, and I'm more motivated to do so. So I feel, you know, when I leave work, I feel much more accomplished as opposed to sort of exhausted in a bad way and rushed and behind. It's just a really big difference. So that comes from writing my to-do list the day before, the night before. I just get on my phone, I pull up a draft email and just write my to-do list there. And that doesn't mean that everything is on that list, but it's a running to-do list. So I'll add to it throughout the day, of course, as things pop up. But the key is knowing what I'm going to do as soon as I get to work. So those are my tips for today. And thank you, Jessica. This is, you know, these are some of the things that I do. And so if you have any questions about anything, please just let me know, and I'd be happy to help you. Again, my course is called Thriving as a Teacher, and I think I put the link in the chat, but if not, I can type that in again. So let me see here. If not, that's okay. You can find it easily, find it on my Facebook page or just DM me.